Good morning, this is Stephen Whiteside with your daily market outlook for Monday, April 14th, 2008. In the pre-market this morning, we've got futures down across the board. Retail sales just came out and futures were up a little bit, but not a lot. So we've got S&P futures down 8, NASDAQ futures down 13. They've been pared back a little bit. This number down at the bottom here, this Dow futures number, forget that. It looks like the Dow futures are currently down about 40 points. Overnight in Asia, we had a big sell-off. Hang Seng market was down over 800 points. The Nikkei in Japan was down over 400 points. So we are looking for a weaker open Monday morning at 9:30. Now, Wachovia, the big U.S. bank, reported weaker than expected numbers, and it's down 10% in the pre-market this morning. Now, looking at our panic zone charts, in all cases, we are still projecting higher prices for all of the major indexes. Unfortunately, mathematical projections don't take into the fact that the underpinnings of the market are still continuing to deteriorate. So the TSX ran up to resistance. We got an early warning signal up there at the top last week, and so it looks like we're starting to move lower. Now, what's different about the Canadian market versus the U.S. market is, for the most part, we made a higher low in March. Last time the market ran down. So we're going to look for the TSX to continue to make a higher low when it starts to sell off, probably starting this week. Now in the U.S. market, such as the S&P 500, again, we were projecting higher prices, but again, mathematical projections don't take into account the deteriorating underpinnings of the market. So we ran up to resistance. We got an early warning signal last week, and when the market starts to roll over and move lower, we are going to be looking to see if we make a higher low or a lower low on the S&P 500. So far, we've made a lower low, and we're going to look to see what happens as the market starts to fall. Now, the NASDAQ, similar situation. We ran up to resistance. We've had two early warning signals, and it looked like the market finally broke down on Friday. And again, we're going to look to see what happens as we move lower here. Do we move lower and make a lower low or a higher low? On a short-term basis, all of the major indexes are oversold, so the S&P 500 is certainly oversold, and we could look for a reaction move higher. To see that happen on Monday, we would need to see an hourly close above 1352. Looking at the VIX had a nice move up last week, and as you can see, it made a higher low. We've moved up to the 2324 area, and that is right where the hourly flypaper channel is, and so we're going to look out for a breakout above that flypaper channel to tell us that this market is really seriously going to move lower. And then we've got some gaps up here that could probably act as resistance on the way up, and then we have a lot of resistance right up here at the 30 level, and so that could be our second target to the upside. So we'll see what happens. First thing we need to do is break out above the flypaper channel to make sure to confirm that that downtrend is in place. Looking at the NASDAQ, similar situation. We are oversold on a short-term basis. We are still projecting lower prices here, of course. We would need to see an hourly close above 2325 on Monday to give us a new intraday buy signal. Don't think that's going to happen. As you can see, we've got a nice open gap on the chart right here. So both the top and the bottom of that open gap could act as resistance if we decide to move higher. I doubt that's going to happen on Monday. Looking at some daily charts for the commodities, the GLD has been moving sideways. I believe that gold is down, still down in the pre-market this morning. So we would need to see a daily close below $90 on this ETF to give us a new sell signal. Silver, we would need to see a daily close below 173. And looking at the energy ETFs, oil still making new highs up there. It is up in the pre-market this morning. We would need to see a daily close below 84.25 to give us a new sell signal this week. And on the natural gas ETF, we would need to see a daily close below 46.50 on Monday. Okay, that's all for Monday morning, folks. Have a great day, and we'll talk to you again on Tuesday morning.